Hi there, and welcome back to our next video on Selenium with C# and MSTest framework in Lambda test series. And in this video, I'll be discussing about how we can run the Selenium C# with MSTest framework test in the Lambda test platform. So far we have been discussing about what is MSTest framework and how to create and set up MSTest framework in Visual Studio. And we also discussed how to run Selenium UI test with MSTest framework in the local machine and running the parallel Selenium UI test with MSTest framework with cross-browser in the local grid setup. While we were discussing all these things in our earlier videos, we also saw there were some limitations while running the test in the local grid setup. Well, the limitations are pretty evident, and the reason being the Selenium Grid setup needs to be always up and running and should have all the browsers and browser versions and operating system combinations in our infrastructure, and the cost in setting up those infrastructure are really, really higher because all these browsers and the operating systems and their availability as well as maintaining different nodes is always a complex and challenging job. But in order to avoid these limitations, we need to get into a platform which can really make these things much easier and sophisticated. So hence, welcome to LambdaTest platform. Well, LambdaTest Selenium Automation Grid enables us to perform the end-to-end automation test on a secure, reliable, and scalable Selenium infrastructure. We can perform automated cross-browser testing with Selenium scripts on 2000 plus browsers and operating systems environment. We can also perform automated cross-browser testing of a locally hosted web application using Lambda test tunneling. So these are some of the ways that we can improve our automated testings in a much, much easier fashion using Lambda test platform. And this also resolves the limitations that we have to maintain the infrastructure by ourselves. Well, as that said, what are we going to discuss in this particular video to make these things happen? Well, we are going to be discussing a lot of things in this video. Especially, we're going to discuss how to configure Lambda test platform integration in the local Selenium code that we wrote in our earlier videos, and how to run parallel Selenium grid setup in the Lambda test Selenium automation grid, and how to perform cross-platform and cross-browser testing with Lambda test, and how to run locally hosted application in Lambda test platform via Lambda tunneling. So these are the things that we'll be discussing in this particular video. So let's get started. So this is the code that we have been writing in all these days in our earlier videos. But today we are going to enhance this code to run on the Lambda test platform. But before starting to really work with the Lambda test platform, let's quickly look at how the Lambda test platform itself is going to look like. Well, this is the Lambda test platform that we are going to be using to perform running the cross browser testing with 2000 plus browser combinations. And as you can see within this Lambda test platform, we have a nice little dashboard. It shows all the details of the concurrent tests that we can execute and how many tests is totally been executed and how many real-time tests been executed, how many screenshot tests has been executed and responsive test has been executed in this particular time frame. And also we can leverage the power of the automated testing that we are going to be doing in this particular video to connect our existing Selenium test and run that within the Lambda test Selenium grid setup. So as you can see within this automation tab, you have something called as get started and run in cloud. So if you click this get started, you get all the details to configure your test code with Lambda test platform. It gives you what host URL that you should be using and what is the username that you should be using and what is the access key. And these are the details, something which is available as an example here with the desired capabilities that you can use to set up all the details like the platform, browser name, versions, resolutions, network, visual, video, and things of that nature. So these are the details required for your test to connect with the Lambda test platform itself. And the most important three things that we really need to have in place are the hub URL, the username, and the access key. So once we have these details, we could able to connect with the Lambda test platform from our code. So I'm just going to quickly start doing that with our existing code, but just that we are going to add a lot of additional capabilities this time. So if we get to our code with our WebDriver init.cs file, you could see that we actually have not really used any capabilities so far. All we have did in our earlier videos were just to get the browser options, but we have not really did any capabilities itself. And also, we can note here that we only have passed the browser type so far within our get web driver. The reason being, our machine is limited to just one operating system, which is Windows operating system, and only the browser that we can pass in, but not the versions of the browser that we can test. Because if we need to test with multiple browsers, then we need to have those multiple browsers installed within the same machine, which we can't really do unless until we uninstall the earlier versions from our machine. But now with the power of Lambda test, we can really achieve all these things. Well, as I said, our parameters are now going to be a bit changed this time than compared to what we have been passing these days. Within this get web driver, we are going to start passing in some more additional details like the platform, versions, and names within it. And it's going to look something like this. So we have this browser type, platform, versions, and names. So once we have this platform, versions, and name, we need to then add the additional capabilities within this method, which is going to look something like this. And as you can see, it's going to have additional capabilities to accept the platform, versions, name, build, users, and the access key. So this user and the access keys are something that we are going to be getting from our Lambda test platform itself, which are nothing but these two. So we are going to pass these two details within our constructor somewhere within this particular class so that we can start using it. And it's going to look something like this. So now we have everything that is required for our browser options as a capability, and all we need to do is to replace our local Selenium grid setup to the Lambda test connectivity so that we can connect to our Lambda test platform itself, and it's going to look something like this. And as you can see, it has the HTTPS because it's a secured socket layer, and it is going to be connecting with the username and password that we have passed and at hub.lambdatest.com/wd/hub. So instead of the local Selenium web driver, we are now connecting to the remote Selenium web driver, which is nothing but the remote Lambda test Selenium grid setup. So we have all these details right now, which means we are now pretty much good to go, but just that we get some errors from where we are calling this particular method because we need to pass those additional parameter within themselves because it's not passed so far. In order to do so, we are actually going to add these additional parameters as well within our test method, something like this. But as you would imagine, these parameters like platform, versions, and name have not been passed within our data row so far. And without this, the test is not really going to be executing. In order to execute that, we are going to pass some additional informations like Windows 10 operating system, run the version of browser as 89, and run the Chrome test for us, something like that. And once we have all these details, we also need to pass those parameters within the get web driver. And that's exactly the same thing we need to do for our other test method, which is going to be something like this. And we also need to pass the parameters for this particular test method. And we can pass the data row for this particular test as well. So now that we have all those details over here, let's try to build this whole solution. And we can see if we could execute this particular test on the Lambda test platform. So now to do that, I'm just going to select both the test methods and then I'm just going to hit the run. So once we run this test this time, these tests are going to start executing within the Lambda test platform instantly because now it is being connected with the Lambda test platform itself. So as you can see, once I execute this test, it is automatically starting this parallel browser testing for us over here. And it says new data is available and it says two concurrent tests are running. And once I click this parallel browser testing, it is showing us the Chrome test and the Edge test for us. And it's also showing one more new data coming in and it shows all the data which are coming up for us over here. It is running the test on the Mac operating system in the Mac OS Catalina for the Chrome browser. It's also running on the Windows 10 for the Firefox browser and for the Chrome browser and Edge Chrome browser. So it's running on different versions of these browsers in different operating systems just instantly by running all of them in parallel. So if we click this play button, it is also going to show us the complete test being executed on these operating system instantly from the Lambda test platform. So this eliminates a lot of pains that we had with our, because all the heavy lifting is being covered by the Lambda test platform. So this way we could see that we could able to run the cross-browser, cross-platform testing in parallel using MSTest framework in Selenium C# with the power of Lambda test platform. The last option that we'll be discussing is the Lambda test platform's tunneling option. So using this tunneling option, we can run our local test within the Lambda test platform instead of running all the remote tests that we have been executing all these days. So if you see, instead of running the publicly hosted application that we have been testing all these days, we have this application lambdatest.github.io sample to do app, and this application is actually hosted on a publicly hosted domain, but we have to replace this to run our locally hosted application. We actually have this application running within our local machine, which is going to be this one. So if I click this, it's going to take us to this to-do HTML, and this is something coming from the 127.0.0.1.8080 of to-do.html. So this is basically my local application running within my local machine, and we are going to be executing this application within the Lambda test platform. And this can be achieved using the Lambda test's tunneling option, which we can actually find from the Lambda test over here. So if you go to the Lambda test platform, we have something called as configure tunnel options right here. So once we click that, it gives us an option to execute this tunneling within a special binary, which we can download from here. So once we download this binary, it is going to extract it, and it's going to show us the lt.exe file. And this exe file can be executed using this command that is given over here. So we can just copy this command, and then we can start executing it within that particular binary that we have got. So in order to do that, I'm just going to navigate to the location where I have downloaded Lambda test tunnel application, and I'm going to paste the command that I'm going to be copying from here. And once we run this, you could see that it is going to start a tunneling option for us, something like launching tunnel. And once the tunnel is being launched, we can then see that it is going to be displayed as over here. If we refresh our page, like tunnel is active, which means now we can run our locally hosted application within the Lambda test platform. But we also need to make a simple code change within our Selenium test so that we can tell that this is the capability that we need to be using to run our locally running test to use the locally hosted application, which we can do using a capability called as tunnel. So using this tunnel capability, we could tell our Selenium grid, which is nothing but the Lambda test Selenium grid, to actually use the capability of tunneling option to be used, which is going to make our code start executing. And this is how the code is going to look like. And once we have everything in place, we can now run the same test from our local machine, and it's going to start using the locally hosted application within the Lambda test platform. So I'm just going to change the name of our test from parallel browser testing to parallel browser testing local, so that we can differentiate that they are actually running the local tests. And then I'm just going to right click and run these tests this time. So once I do that, instantly Lambda test is super smart enough to show us the new test starting to pop in. And we can see that we have the parallel browser testing local coming in for us, and it's running two tests in parallel. And if we open them, you could see that it is starting to run the tests for us. And if we see our local application over here, you could see the requests are actually coming in. And these requests are actually coming in from the Lambda test platform for us, because the Lambda test platform is actually running the real application for its testing purposes. And if we see the new data to be loaded, you could see that all the tests are actually executed. And if I open any of the test, and if I play the video of how the test is being executed, you could see that the URL is 127.0.0.1:8080/to-do.html, which means it is actually using our locally hosted application to to run the test within the Lambda test platform. And the same is actually happening multiple different operating systems and multiple different browsers. So this shows that tunneling is actually working much, much easily to run our tests on Lambda test platform using a simple code change within our MSTest code using Selenium C#. So that's about all the discussion that we discussed about Lambda test platform and Selenium C# and MSTest framework. Hope you really liked this whole series. And also hope you really enjoyed using the Lambda test platform for using and extending the capability of Selenium test in multiple different browsers, in multiple different operating systems, and multiple different versions of browsers, making the testing much, much easier and realistic.
As always, please post any questions in the comments below or at community.lambdatest.com. See you in the next video.